Hare Krishna. So I've been in Mayapur since 1979, and this place is a very magic place. From the very beginning, I have felt in my heart something changing, and I felt this is a very spiritual, powerful place where times lapse. When you are in Mayapur, at one point you don't know what day of the week is it, what month of the year is it, what year it is. It's like you are living in another dimension, completely, totally immersed in chanting and dancing with the devotees and performing devotional service. So throughout my spiritual life, I've been doing so many different variety of service, starting from cleaning the toilet in the long buildings and cleaning the kitchen, cooking with the devotees, and doing Sankirtan for 10 years, distributing Srila Prabhupada books, starting the Harinam party, Food for Life, and Namahatta with Guru Maharaj, His Holiness Jayapataka Swami, and many other great devotees. We were traveling from village to village, bringing the holy name, as predicted by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, that every town and village my name would be sung. So we were traveling everywhere and trying to distribute books, prasadam, and bring people to Mayapur. In the beginning, not so many people used to come to Mayapur. I was in Calcutta serving at the time as a temple commander. It was 1982 or 83. And at the time, the temple president of Calcutta, His Grace Adridharan Prabhu, actually visited this holy place. And people usually start to come, some life member, some friends. We used to give free ticket and, you know, or charge very nominal 50 rupees for the fuel. And I personally drove the bus, and it was very nice program. All the people will come in the bus. I will introduce myself. I am your driver. I'm from Italy. I'm going to drive you to Mayapur. And I make all the people chant Hare Krishna. And we had a small television. At the time, the VHF tape, and we put a video about Mayapur and Srila Prabhupada. And people used to be feeling very happy. And so, from the time, of course, slowly, there was only long building and a conch building. And the temple was under the lotus building, this temple. And there was only Radha Madhava, there was not Didi, no other gopis. And there was a big kitchen with a small godown. Or you can say like fire. If you put iron in contact with fire, that iron takes the same quality as the fire, and anything you touch will burn. So similarly, the spiritual, powerful place called Mayapur is such a powerful spiritual potency which everybody can perceive. So the only name is what is supporting and is spreading from this holy place throughout the world. Srila Prabhupada wanted that all the devotee comes at least once in a year from all over the world and recharge their spiritual battery so they could go back and continue the mission of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, which is to actually spread the mercy of the Lord. Because that is our movement. We want to make everybody happy. We want to make everybody closer to the Lord.